The squad making sure we all win. Smoke a lot radio, we going all in. Zilla, I'm the host with the most smoke. Rolling up the most dope. Kato got the most jokes. Simone Taylor, keep it sexy for the grown folks. I'm OG, tone low, bouncing on them ghost folks. Smoke, we the number one podcast. Some other shows, all trash. Amber Rose, all ass. Broadcasting live from the coast. Sick committee with the jokes. Come and get your ass, bro.
Speaking of faces of death, man. Now, we niggas from the Bay, man, and we start maneuvering to L.A. and shit, fuck with niggas like T.Y. and shit, you know what I mean, going up under, you know what I mean, real loved ones that had our back out there. Now, we Bay niggas, man, so Bay niggas naturally say blood. Yeah, I mean, that's like, what's up, homeboy? What's up, my nigga? That's like that, but we say blood, man. We come from Black Panthers and love and all that shit for our black people, so we like, what up, blood?
Yeah.
So, when we come to L.A. and we say blood, niggas look at us like a certain way, man. You know what I mean? And we like the color red. For some reason, Bay niggas like to wear red. So, Drew, you had a situation, man, to where you was trapped in a Crip neighborhood, and they thought you was the blood.
Yeah. Well, first they thought you was the blood.
No, you tell the story, my nigga, because I wasn't there. But that story was mainly.
That story is long.
No, this is short version. This is short version. We go.
From where?
Inside? Just tell from where you got there in the car. You know what I mean? In the red car.
So when I'm there, it's a little nigga coming down. I think.
Hold on. Just tell you, Drew Dale pull up in the Crip neighborhood in the red car. Now, this is where the story starts.
60th. That's where I was at.
You was in the roller 60s.
I was definitely in the roller 60s. And I had red, black Jordans on, black 501.
I don't know what year this was, so they won't think it's like current.
Yeah, I think it was like 98.
Good.
97, yeah. Somewhere around there. Might be, yeah.
96. I think I'm 96.
So everybody watching, these is B TMC years before the marathon was even. So this is different type of Crippin' era. I want to make sure y'all know the essence of this story. Yes. The era is very serious of this story.
Yes.
Hey, but the nigga that rolled down the street, he said he thought it was Nip. He thought it was a little Nip.
I still think it was Nip. You feel me? I ain't gonna lie. I don't know if it was. I don't know if it was.
Not 98. Not 98.
Nip wasn't banging back.
Not 98.
Yeah, just Nip wasn't banging back then.
97.
Yeah. Not then yet. Not yet.
He was too young, huh?
Yeah, he was too young.
That was my nigga. What's McCallit, man? My nigga that died there. I'm there, Richie. Was my nigga Richie a nigga? What's his name? From the 60s?
Sandman.
That probably was young Sandman on your ass, boy.
I don't know who the fuck it was, but do he look like Nipsey?
Yeah, with the ponytail.
It's a lot of the culture of Eritreanism over there. But
this nigga didn't have long hair at the time. This was just on the bike. You feel me? He was a young nigga. You feel me? You could tell he just a nigga on the bike. You feel me? At this time, probably a lookout nigga. You feel me? It didn't matter. But the whole point is the nigga, but the you and you feel me? Like, what's up, cuz? I like threw up the five on him. Like, you feel me? That's my
right.
Husband. I just right. Think. Waving most of the time, but nigga, this the hood. You feel me? But I look, and that nigga just said, nigga just start taking off, right?
Boy, from the hood.
He going up to the blocks where the liquor store at. Okay.
The homies know.
And so I got the little bitch in the car. She like, Daddy, they, we need to get up out of here because her auntie then came and took the motherfucking keys to the car, right? So we stuck in the motherfucker. You feel me? You feel me? She's like, baby, she ain't coming out. She said, you got to come in. I'm like, bitch, what the fuck do you mean you got to come in, bitch? You feel me? And I'm right next to a candlelight where a motherfucker just got killed right there.
The camera. Already they got knocked down.
Yeah, I'm looking at this shit like, bitch, you tripping. Next thing you know, nigga, nigga, here come a car, left side, right side, all full with niggas. Car coming down, Dukes are had of us. Niggas get on top of the car with choppers. Nigga, the whole shit just look like a bee just swarmed this shit. You feel me? And niggas like, then the back of the car get hit with a yellow van. Bam! And we go up like this. She crying. Matter of fact, I got a 380 with two bullets. I had a 380 with two bullets. Nigga, I'm like, ugh.
It's a wrap. Bullets ain't gonna handle shit.
Hey, it was about 60 niggas for sure. For sure. At least 60 niggas.
Right. FBI pull up.
And then the van got hit from the back. They hit us with the van from the back. And then, bada bing, nigga, I look, and the nigga walk past, like, yeah, nigga, fuck 415, bro, 60 Crip, cuz, right? I was like, okay, right? I end up seeing this nigga later on down the line, though. You feel me? We really got it up, though, because he's a YA baby. You feel me? So we already had problems, just me and him. It had nothing to do with the Rolling 60 shit. It was just me and him. You know what I'm talking about? But the whole point is, nigga, OG said, no, a young nigga said to an OG way back in the summer, nigga, because I had ocean waves at this time, nigga, and I rolled the window down, stuck my head out a little bit so they could see them things. Like, nigga, I'm not from here.
Right.
You got to see these, nigga. This pimp.
You got to see this dude. Yeah,
this,
come on,
this,
man.
This from Oakland, nigga. No LA.
The only nigga at that dude was Rodney O. Rodney O is the only one was rocking that on our side. Nobody else. Nobody else.
So, yeah, they looking at the youngster say, man, I think that's true damn, man. He said, nah, there ain't no true damn. He said, man, I think that is, right? Next thing you know, OG come through the crowd like, much up, boom, boom, boom. He said, hey, man, you true damn? I'm like, you know, I didn't know if I wanted to say yeah, no, at the time. I didn't know how nigga was going to react. You feel me? I got to see a nigga's motions and see how they feel.
Hey, on my mama, let me read you.
Faces and reaching, yeah. And I'm like, yeah, man, Jalen, man. He said, okay, cuz. He said, that's how he said, though. He said, okay, cuz. He said, check this out. He said, I'm going to give you a pass right now, man. He said, my nigga just got killed right here last night. You see all this goddamn candlelights, man? My nigga just got killed right here last night. He said, I'm going to give you a pass, man, to get up out of here, man. I said, all right, man. He said, man, yeah. He said, yeah, my little homie just said you was Drew down. So, yeah. You look like Drew down too. Some shit look funny, kind of funny. Like,
you might be, you might not. But
yeah, you know, kind of getting kind of closer and looking like, you feel me? Like, boom. So the nigga cut. They all go back to the liquor store. I'm still in the motherfucking car. You feel me? I'm still in this motherfucking car. I'm still in this bitch. Hey, right? Now it's getting nighttime. There ain't no reason to stay in the car. It's not going to happen. You feel me? So, the girl said, man, you might as well just go come on in. I said, man, had to get my shit together. Let's go.
Let's go on in.
I ain't about to stay in the street. You feel me? Going all the way in this motherfucker, right? I'm talking about, nigga, the brawl had the situation problem. This bitch, she in the middle of her grandmama and auntie, right? So I see this bitch, and when I walk in, nigga, I lock the door, and then I look, niggas, 8 locks on the door. 6 to 8 locks on this motherfucker. Click, 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 click. The OG.
Like you had James J. Evans
out. Click, 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 right? And I say, bitch, why the fuck you got me in the middle of the street? What the fuck is you doing? She said, fuck you, nigga. You ain't gonna have me talking to hella slobs around the corner. So I was just at a store around the corner talking to hella bloods because I walked into a store to get some
glasses. And they was friendly. They was cool. They
were
tripping.
Damn, what's happening, homie? Let's smoke with me, nigga. Boom. So I end up smoking with the niggas. Boom, wham, wham. Hey, boom.
That's a classic case of, man, Crips be tripping.
She like, nigga, you fucking with them slob ass niggas. She hit 2 or 3 corners. We are on 65th and 6th.
No disrespect to the blood, y'all. He telling the story.
Yeah, this is
you motherfuckers in the comments.
No disrespect to the Rolling 60s. He's telling the story.
Oh, they know what's up. But you got to talk to the motherfuckers. My bad, Drew. Keep it cracking.
Yeah, man, real shit right here, man. But you feel me? Yeah, so that happened, boom, boom, boom. And then, next day, you know, nigga, I'm in that joint, nigga. I just knocked this bitch smooth the fuck out.
I mean, somebody had to get it at this point. At this point.
I wasn't ready for that.
Between her grandmama and her, she sit right in the middle. I come across that kitchen table like, bitch, what you do?
Come on, man.
Gave her to Kenny Rogers.
Look what grandmama hit me with. My old school grandmama used to say this too. Oh, Lordy.
He heard my cry.
Why you do that, baby? I said, Grandma, I'm not even. Yeah, she got me about to be killed out here. You feel me? By the time I did all this, I asked her if she got a gun in the house. She said, no. I went straight to the joint, got me hella steak knife. You feel me? Next thing I know, you feel me? Niggas is throwing cans and rocks all onto the window, scaring everybody in the house. You feel me? I go to the motherfucking shower, nigga, down the hall.
What the fuck y'all tripping on?
It, man,
thought you had a pass.
Bro, hold on. Long story short, nigga.
The OG went home.
Go ahead. He went to the house. Yeah, he sleep now.
OG went home.
Now they want to see what kind of chain Drew Down got on.
They want it. Nigga, I go to the motherfucker shower, right? And try to go out the window of the shower. You know that I got the little window right there.
A small joint. Yeah. Nigga, the kitchen party window. That's the kitchen party window.
They got the whole alley full. These niggas. Talk about the loonies. Talking about, yeah.
In the loonies, don't that nigga say blood?
Come on, nigga.
This shit was your fault, yuck, the whole shit.
This nigga was dressed.
It's not your verse, it's
numbers. Diamond red, nigga. This nigga had all red on. This nigga pulled up in a red Suzuki, Volkswagen, whatever the fuck that little car that bitch had. You know what happened, nigga.
No, but that ain't what I'm saying. I'm telling about what they said in the alley while I was hanging over there. And they didn't see me. You feel me? I'm listening. These niggas saying, yeah.
And don't one of them lonely niggas say blood. Them niggas bloods, right? They ain't talking about me. They talking about y'all at this time, right?
And
so yeah, you didn't get them in the virgin, nigga, but you got them into that bullshit in that alley in the 60s.
Hey, why would I turn around? It's a nigga in the house that I don't know. Nigga, I got these steak knives. Nigga, I come down the hallway like this. Nigga, I'm about to give it to him. Like, nigga, they like, yo, he's a friend of the family.
Oh, them bitches be play brothered out. This is some play brother having bitches.
Hey, this nigga kept it 100 with me. He was a different type of greedy when he got it. But I felt it. That nigga said, he said, Drew, you can't go nowhere.
There's nowhere to go.
matter of fact, Grandma said, baby, you need to come out of all that dead. I said, I don't give a fuck. Take these shoes.
It's like that movie, 35 and Chicken.
Bro, they made the nigga come out of all that red clothes, nigga.
The bitch had the goddamn red on.
The nigga that came in there gave him his clothes. Nigga, you can't come out in red, nigga.
No, this what happened, nigga. Look, nigga, I took that shit off. Grandma came back with some girl blue shoes and a blue blouse, talking about this all I got, baby. I said, oh, well, shit, I'm about to die today. Today, I'm about to die. You feel me?
I ain't put on no goddamn blue blouse.
I ain't about to turn into Wanda just to get out the 60s.
That guy, I wouldn't give a fuck. I was about to go to hell, nigga. He said, nigga, you might as well just knock down on the floor.
OG from the 60s came through that bitch, basically.
yeah, automatically, and then boom.
No. Gov called a nigga from the OG from the
60s. I called Gov, and Gov called a nigga, and then boom. You feel me? I end up making it out there, motherfucker. Make a long story short, end up making it out there, motherfucker. Because of Gov and the homie. Damn,
bro, they didn't make you put on blue. They didn't make you put on blue.
No, nigga, I ain't wearing that shit. No, hell no, nigga. I kept my shirt off, had that under my arm, nigga. Came out with my t-shirt and my motherfucking shoes on, nigga. And nigga, when I hit the sidewalk, nigga, I just made a left and left both of the bitches. Nigga, shot to her car because I had the keys. Nigga jumped in. My bitch jumped in the passenger side, and she jumped in, nigga, hanging on for dear life, nigga. She lucky she made it, nigga. She was getting drugged for a little half a block, nigga. She was like,
bitch was looking like the Dukes of Hazzard around this motherfucker.
Yeah, nigga.
and got to the hotel. When we get to the hotel, then the whole crew whooped mine. Remember?
Right. Yeah. Right. Yeah, we was at the Motel 6 on goddamn Sunset Boulevard.
No, we weren't no damn Motel 6, nigga. We was at the Lamonte or something, LaDuffy or something. That's what it's called.
No, the Days Inn, whatever that shit called. That's what we used to stay in back then. That's where we even met the bitches. Remember they used to come
This was before the Days Inn, because we were staying at the LaDuffy.
This after the Days Inn, you mean? Because when we first went to L.A., we was at the Days Inn. Right next to the Fat Burger.
You're right. Yeah.
They had the swimming pool. We had all our bitches through that. We made the Days Inn, the motherfucking Montrose. That motherfucker was lit when we was in that bitch.
We had Jodeci in that motherfucker.
Jodeci, everybody, corrupt all the niggas. Nigga, everybody was through there. Nigga, Death Row niggas, everybody was through that motherfucker, nigga. T.Y., nigga, Low Riders popping through that bitch. We was right there. That's where I met. I ain't gonna go.
West Coast legendary shit on Smoke a Lot Radio tonight, y'all.
That's when you hit a.
That's when I met Gonzo baby mama before it was his baby mama. That's why we was in the beef. Remember, I met her right in front of the motherfucking Days Inn. She had the red bands.
Remember when you had to jump over the balcony?
Oh yeah, definitely. Come on, man. There was a lot of shit going on in that hotel. That hotel was main.
Why you had to jump over the balcony?
Don't worry about that.